Alrighty, what is going on everybody? It's Juicy Boxman, and today I'm bringing you level 17 Gyrosphere Valley free play on LEGO Jurassic World. We're going to be getting all 10 minikits, the Amber Brick, and the True Survivor Score for 50,000 studs. Of course, like all the recent levels, I'm going to be getting True Survivor pretty much instantly due to my red brick multipliers, just so you guys aren't completely surprised or anything. So, right off the bat, this level is started with a chase scene. Now, there's going to be three wooden posts that you are going to want to hit. So, immediately stay on this right side. Not exactly all the way to the right, but as soon as the camera turns that first time, as you guys saw right there, we will get post number one. Now, we have to go under two bridges. The second one, Indominus Rex, breaks it, but then we get to this forest area. As soon as we get here, you want to stay all the way to the left this time to collect post number two. Now, as soon as you get that second post, you want to immediately go all the way up, maybe possibly even jump if you have to, as you guys see here on the screen, because you definitely want to make sure you're all the way up on this upper path. So, as you guys saw right there, we will get the Amber Brick on the way to the third post, which is also all the way up in this section. So we got our first mini kit and the Amber Brick. There are quick links in the description below if you do get confused at any point in this video. Now when we get to the checkpoint, you want to turn into your Headbutt Dinosaur and take this rock out over here for your mini kit number two. I was kind of confused here why. Like, I completely forgot that one of the characters has to stay in the gyrosphere or whatever to complete parts of story progression, like this part right here. Most of the traps that we set for Mr. Indominus Rex. So, after the story progression, you'll notice over here, I was kind of like trying to find a different character. I always use Barry, but he's in the gyrosphere. So I had to find a different character with a grapple. But you want to grapple up on that tree, climb on up, and get minikit number three before we head on over here. Now, you want to change into someone with a claw or a knife to cut these vines off so that whoever's in the gyrosphere can jump over to this hidden area in order to get minikit number four. And then we're going to head back on up so we can change into our Dilophosaurus, because there is a black glowing rock over here. Once you use your spit, it does take quite a while, even with the video sped up. But you'll get minikit number 5 for your efforts. If you guys saw right there in the corner of the screen, I was checking out that minikit that's floating in the air. We're actually going to get that in the next section after this second dino fight scene. There's a ton of these dino fight scenes in the game. I always thought they were pretty hilarious. But anyways, we're going to get two mini kits over here after we build some stuff. You want to head down into the stream, use your crowbar as Nick Van Owen to get your next mini kit number 6. And then immediately, we got to build these bones to make a little trampoline to get up in the tree. Don't go right yet. Don't go right down that vine. You want to use your parachute and fly over and collect that floating minikit that we saw earlier. And then we can, you know, gyrosphere jump over to the next section and then slide on down the vine with our other character. Do the final. Oh, wait, I'm not sure if it's the final. It might be. The third dino fight scene. And then before heading to the next area, you want to switch to someone with engine panel access in order to open up this little cage on the ground to get minikit number 8. And then right over here, before you do the story progression, you know, like you're supposed to pick up the truck with the crane and drop it on Indominus Rex. Over here to the left, there's a watering hole. So go ahead and grab that for minikit number 9. And then the final minikit is actually at the base of the crane. You want to switch to someone with Jurassic World access for that panel, and that will reward you with your final mini kit for this level. So that's all the collectibles. We really sped through this level, another short one, glad to say. I hope you guys are enjoying the series. It's coming to a close pretty soon. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned. Peace out, guys.